Hello and welcome to the 8th video in the series Linear Algebra for Machine Learning. If you have watched the previous videos, then let me tell you, well done. You deserve a pat on the back, and if you have not already, I strongly recommend that you watch those videos before starting this one. Today, we'll talk about singular value decomposition, or SVD. It is a critical concept and, in my opinion, one of the most beautiful concepts in linear algebra. It is perhaps the most well-known and widely used matrix decomposition method. The SVD has many applications in statistics, machine learning, and computer science, such as computing the pseudo-inverse of a matrix, image compression, data denoising, and so on. So make sure to watch the video till the end. Let's get started with the video. Remember, in our last video, we discussed eigendecomposition, that is, representing a matrix in terms of its eigenvalues and eigenvectors. We know that for any full-rank square matrix A, the matrix Q is a square matrix such that the ith column of Q is the eigenvector of A corresponding to the eigenvalue in the ith row of lambda. Small problem is that eigendecomposition is only defined for square matrices. So what about factorizing rectangular matrices? For rectangular matrices, we turn to singular value decomposition, or SVD. It has been referred to as the fundamental theorem of linear algebra because it can be applied to all matrices, not only to square matrices, and it always exists. In case of SVD, every real matrix A with a size m cross n can be factorized as A equals U times D times V transpose. Such a formulation is known as singular value decomposition, or SVD. Here, the columns of U are known as the left singular vectors of matrix A. Also, U is an orthogonal matrix. The columns of V are known as the right singular vectors of the matrix A, and V is also an orthogonal matrix. And D is a diagonal matrix containing singular values of the matrix A. Also, note that U and V are square matrices. The diagonal matrix D is not square, unless A is a square matrix. You may have noticed that in the case of eigendecomposition, we had eigenvalues and eigenvectors, whereas in SVD, we have singular values and singular vectors. Also, the role played by U, D, and V transpose are similar to those of Q, lambda, and Q inverse in eigendecomposition. But that similarity ends there. Here is an important statement that people have trouble remembering. The SVD of a square matrix may not be the same as its eigendecomposition. In fact, they coincide if and only if the matrix is symmetric and positive definite. Since U and V equals Q and the diagonal matrix D is the same as the matrix lambda. In general though, the SVD and eigendecomposition of a square matrix are different. The most important differences are that singular values are always non-negative, but eigenvalues can be negative. Also, the matrices U and V in the SVD are always orthogonal, but the matrix Q in an eigendecomposition may not be orthogonal. A symmetric matrix guarantees orthonormal eigenvectors. Other square matrices do not. Some interesting relationships hold for rectangular matrices. Now we know that for any rectangular matrix A, the matrix A transpose times A is a square symmetric matrix. So eigendecomposition is possible for the matrix A transpose times A. Moreover, it has real eigenvalues and orthonormal eigenvectors. Therefore, we can substitute A for U times D V transpose. And let's solve this equation. Here, we have used the fact that U transpose times U is an identity matrix since U is an orthogonal matrix. Now, what conclusions can you draw from this equation? Pause the video and try to interpret the equation. The columns of V are actually the eigenvectors of the matrix A transpose times A. Furthermore, the singular values along D's diagonal are the square roots of A transpose A's eigenvalues. A similar analysis leads to the result that the columns of U are the eigenvectors of A, A transpose. Now that we know that eigen decomposition is different from SVD, it's time to understand the individual components of SVD. We saw in the matrix geometry video that orthogonal matrices rotate and reflect, but never stretch. So that's the role of U and V, both orthogonal matrices, they rotate and reflect. But U is a m cross m matrix and V is an n cross n matrix. So they perform the rotation in different spaces. Since U and V are strictly orthogonal matrices and only perform rotation or reflection, any stretching or shrinkage has to come from the diagonal matrix D. Hence, the diagonal non-zero elements of D, the singular values, are non-negative. Any dimensions with zero singular values are essentially squashed. Dimensions with higher singular values are more dominant, and conversely, those with lower singular values are shrunk. And therein lies the importance of SVD. Let's look at an example. Here, A is a rectangular matrix, and these matrices are the SVD components of A. Notice that the last two rows in D have a less dominant singular value, that is 0.71 and 0. Whereas the first two rows have more dominant singular value, that is 9.64 and 6.36. By focusing on directions of larger singular values, one might ensure that the data, any resulting models, and analyzes about the dominant patterns in the data. This is achieved by sorting the singular values by magnitude and truncating the diagonal matrix to dominant singular values. That will entail corresponding adjustments to the U and V matrices by getting rid of the rows or columns that correspond to lower singular values. So if we are focused on the R top singular values, then we can construct an approximate or compressed version of matrix A of the original matrix as. This is a great way of compressing a dataset while still retaining the dominant patterns within. In fact, the number of non-zero or positive singular values of a matrix is equal to its rank. Machine learning is all about working with generalizable and dominant patterns in the data. Some details might be lost. In fact, in some cases, it is desirable to ignore irrelevant details to avoid the phenomenon of overfitting. And this is where SVD helps. Since we have this matrix here, let me show you an example of how we can think about this. Assume we are a company like Netflix or YouTube, and this matrix A is a user to movie rating matrix, which means that for every person who watches a movie or video on our platform, they give us a rating. So a value of 1 means they didn't like the movie. A value of 5 means they enjoyed that movie. And a value of 0 means the user has not watched that movie or has not rated it. So each column in this matrix corresponds to a different movie. And each row corresponds to a different user. For example, for user 1, Aditya, who watched Star Wars, Blade Runner, and really liked these movies, while he didn't like Alien. It's clear that this user prefers science fiction movies to romantic movies. Now our goal is to understand user preferences and recommend movies based on the likability of the users who watch similar movies rather than just the genre of the movies. Because genre-based recommendations are likely to be flawed, as different comedy movies can be loved or hated by the same type of user. So if we serve them movies based on the likability of other similar users, users who frequently watch similar movies are more likely to click on the recommended movie. As a result, we will decompose this matrix using SVD to determine which movies should we recommend to any user next. For the two science fiction movies, the first left singular vector has large absolute values and a large first singular value. Notice the red block. As a result, this associates a specific type of user with a specific set of movies, in this case, science fiction. Similarly, Aditya and Aditi, who who give high ratings to science fiction movies have large absolute values in the first right singular vector. Notice the green block. This implies that the first row in V represents the concept of a science fiction fan. Similarly, row 2 in U seems to capture a romantic movie theme, and the second row in V indicates that Ali is close to an idealized fan of such movies. Any idealized science fiction fan is a purist and only likes science fiction movies. So a science fiction fan, notice row 1 in V, gives a rating of 0 to everything but science fiction themed movies. This logic is implied by the diagonal substructure of the singular value matrix D. A specific movie is therefore represented by how it linearly decomposes into its stereotypical movies. Like a user would be represented by how they decompose via linear combination into movie themes. You can interpret the left singular vectors as stereotypical movies and the right singular vectors as stereotypical viewers. As a result, the SVD appears in a variety of machine learning algorithms. I hope this example helps to reinforce what we have been talking about in this video. That's all for now. Thanks for your time. Have a wonderful day. And if you liked what you learned in this video, please share, comment, and subscribe to the channel.